Google Search Console is a powerful tool with lots of functionality and reports. One of the best parts of that, in my opinion, is the URL inspection tool. It looks quite simple and limited at first glance, but it offers a few really useful insights to those who pay attention. If you are using Google Search Console, and you really should, you probably have seen the URL inspection tool. When you select URL inspection or type a URL within the current property into the search bar at the top of the Search Console, you get to the URL inspection tool. At a first glance, it looks pretty basic. It shows us if the URL is indexed, if it has any enhancements, and if it's mobile friendly. But it lets us dig a little deeper than that. So let's investigate. One thing that can be quite useful is to expand on the information presented on the screen here. For example, it tells you about the discovery of this page, if it used a sitemap or a referring page and what that page was. It also shows you the canonical URL you supplied on the page with a link rel canonical tag and the canonical URL Google ended up picking. It also lists the last crawl date, if crawling was allowed, which Googlebot did the crawl, and if indexing is allowed, and if not, why it isn't. For enhancements and mobile friendliness, it takes you to the relevant reports. When you click View Crawled Page, you get a lot of additional information, and this information is super helpful, even if it's tucked on the side here. It starts with the rendered HTML. This is the HTML that Google Search uses for indexing and represents what Google Search saw on the page when it crawled and rendered the page. We can use this together with the search function to check if content is available to Google or not. But the More Info button has even more useful stuff for us. Behind More Info, we find the HTTP response code, and if we expand on that, we also see all the HTTP response headers coming back from the server. This is great to investigate for stray X-Robots directives or other issues with the server configuration. And this isn't the only bit of info we can use to debug issues with a page. Going back and looking at page resources, we see which requests have been made during crawling and rendering, and if they failed, why. For example, here, we see some resources that loaded via JavaScript and failed due to being blocked by robots.txt. If these carry important page content, then this means Google Search would miss out on that content. While we're here, what's up with this other error? Well, that's a tricky one. It usually means something stopped us from fetching that resource, either because we don't really need it for rendering and indexing, like fonts, for example, or because it took us too long to get to it. It usually is a transient thing on Google's side and nothing much to worry about. Going back, the tool also shows us any JavaScript console messages, and these might give you hints about what's going on when the page is rendered. Your developers might be able to make sense of what these messages mean for your specific application. All of this information is not only available for the version of the page that Google recently crawled, but you can also skip any caches and do a live test on this URL. Let's try that now. The live test might give you slightly different results when you run it multiple times. That's because it doesn't use caches, but also can't really wait too long to give you results. So sometimes some resources might not finish crawling quickly enough, and thus the output might differ between runs. Ah, here we go. Once the results come back, we can see what we looked at previously, but we also get a screenshot. A very nice way to get a first glimpse. However, I would suggest focusing on the HTML and the page resources and HTTP response in most cases, though. Well, as you can see, from the simple screen with a few green check marks, you can drill down to the details such as the raw HTTP response, including all response headers, as well as JavaScript console logs and information such as the selected canonical. I hope this was useful for some of you, and if you are interested in more insights to Google Search and related tooling, subscribe to our channel and check out our other videos. Stay safe, have fun, and bye-bye!